Hi, before we go into this video, I just wanted to tell you, I want to really apologize. There'll be a little shake in the video you're going to watch. Right now, I'm shooting with a tripod. We shot that video with a Canon 80D, but it was handheld, so it'll be a little bit shake. And also, I'm looking into improving my, you know, voice quality. I'm looking into a good mic. I'm researching for that now, so hopefully I'll improve it each video. And also, if you like this video, please click the like button after you watch it, and it'll be really nice if you can click the subscribe button to stay tuned for further videos from me. So let's get into the video. Vanakkam, namaste, swadika, hello. So today I'm going to do a Q&A with the questions you guys sent me, so let's get into it right now. Okay, so this is from Tasneem. When did you start learning and teaching yoga? I started learning yoga around 10 years back, but I have not been consistent with my practice consistently for the past 5 years, and I think I went for my teacher's training 2 years back. Next question. The underscore blue underscore green. Okay. Are you basically from Varanasi? No, I'm not from Varanasi. I'm from Tamil Nadu originally, although I really, really love Varanasi. Okay. Shabnam. Is beauty regime necessary to do every day after 30s? I think absolutely yes. Yeah, you must take care of your skin. I mean, as much as you have to drink a lot of fluids and your fitness, I also think skincare is very important. That's all your moisturizers, toners, SPF, whatever, under eye creams. It's really good if you find a good brand and, you know, start using it. Rahul, does life really begin at 40? You need to ask somebody who's 40 that question. Okay, anyway, jokes apart. Yeah, people keep saying that. It's just been like 3 weeks. And I do think life really begins at 40. I think people say that because by the time you reach 40, you just realize that you're going to live life on your own terms. I think you kind of realize that in your late 30s. But by the time you reach 40, you're pretty sure you're just not gonna, you're going to do the things you really love. And maybe that's the reason people say life begins at 40. Varsha, where do you get the ideas of draping sari so beautifully? Share some sari styling idea. I don't know. I don't honestly use saris regularly. I mean, maybe once in 2 months, 3 months. But I just drape them however I feel like. I think today the good part is that you can just do whatever you want as far as you can carry it off. Whatever comes to your mind, you know, as far as you can carry it off. So just style it in any way and just see if you feel happy and if you feel good and if you can carry it off. Fine. Okay, third name I'm not getting. Which is your favorite place? This is so difficult with so many places, but I think I think Kyoto, Japan is one of my favorite countries, and my favorite city is Kyoto. I just love the Zen gardens. Konnichiwa! Arigato gozaimasu! That's my little bit Japanese. Is Samaban India, should one consider the age or the design style as far as personal fashion is concerned? Design style. I don't think age is even a factor to consider if you ask me. I've seen women in their 40s carry off dresses so well. You know, somebody in their 30s may not be able to carry off the same thing. It just depends on your body type, how comfortable you feel and how much you can carry off something, right? If you feel good at something and you feel you can carry it off, then I don't think age should really a factor. Okay, candid colors, Pavan. How did you get interested in fashion? Okay, most of this I already answered in my introduction video, but just to tell you, yeah, I've been interested in fashion for the longest time. Ever since I was a kid, I love fashion. I think, but more of it, just see it in my introduction video. Namrita, please can you advise what are the best things to carry while traveling in terms of clothes, accessories, makeup? See, honestly, this depends from person to person and where you're going. I mean, for example, if you're going to Machu Picchu for trekking or Bhutan or whatever, you'll pack accordingly. And if you're going to Paris or New York, you will pack accordingly. So I just think, you know, so it depends on where you're going and how much you, the person you are, what you would like to wear, what you would, things like that. For me, honestly, sometimes, you know, for 7 days I end up with taking 14 dresses, but I try to limit my shoes and bag, and I've never crossed the weight limit. But it's just, as I said, it's just difference from person to person. Okay, how much role does diet play in fitness versus working out? I think diet is absolutely important. It's extremely important. In fact, like I would say, 60% is diet. You know, there's a saying that abs are made in the kitchen. So you can go to, you know, full like a strength training class or a yoga class, and somebody might tell you, you just came out of a class, eat the cheesecake. Don't listen to them, because your body is actually burning fat after the class. So make sure what you eat after or before is good, you know, good food, healthy food. So yes, diet plays a huge role. Okay. How do you manage your travel finances? Would be very motivating for young travelers. Okay, this is really funny. When I read this question out to my husband, he smirked because he knows I'm this queen of budgeting. So I've always, this, you know, I've been the one who takes care of budgeting, and I have this Excel sheet where I actually put down every month this much for, you know, like expenditures, this month this much for travel, this much for whatever your passion is, whatever you want to do. Even if you want to buy a camera that year, if you whatever you want to do, just budget it monthly, and that really works for me. But I don't know if it's going to work for everybody. Some people just go spend, and you know, they really, it's very difficult to tell people, because you know, everybody functions differently. But I am very organized when it comes to budgeting and spending, and it works for me because it helps me do the things I love. Okay, Hema, here you go. My first question for you: how does someone age gracefully? Something I want to know too. But I think if you do what you love and love what you do, it will really help. The other basic things, get into practices like mindfulness, gratefulness, thankfulness, yoga, meditation. If you find the peace within you, I think it's going to help. And yeah, a lot of sleep and water, eating healthy, just a bunch of factors. But do what you love and love what you do and be happy. Okay, Uma, how to save and work and travel and be happy in every stage when we are young itself? Do share, smiling queen. This is a question I answered earlier. So yes, it all comes down to budgeting. If you have, you know, if you're earning X amount, put it out on an Excel sheet and say, you know, split it out to what all you want to do. So it really helps, and you'll be able to be more organized with your finances and saving for the things you want to do. And I think that should make you happy. It makes me happy when I'm very clear, you know. And okay, hi ma'am, how's life, your life? And tell me about your photography. Yeah, my photography, I don't know what I'm going to say, because I have so much to learn. It's a relatively new hobby, probably 2 years at the time I got on Instagram too. Almost 2 years, I think. So yeah, it's just, I'm constantly learning. There's so much to learn. Yeah, so I don't know anything to say about photography, because I really have to learn a lot more. Okay, how you keep smiling always, dear? I don't think my doctors are going to agree with this. There are sometimes I'm not smiling because they're driving me insane. But yes, for the most part, I just think I have this habit of smiling all the time. You know, I've never pouted. Even in pictures, I rarely pout. I have this horrible habit. That's my standard pose. I don't know how, but I'm smiling. Somesh, how will you define photography? I think photography is a balance of art and a science. How much percentage of each, I wouldn't know. I think more of a science. Honestly, the technical part is a lot, and that's what I really struggle with. So I would say 30% to 40% art. The remaining, it's more on technicality and the equipment and all those things. So yeah, it's a combination. Share some of your blog writing experiences, struggles, stability and success of your blog. First of all, I don't think my blog is successful. I'm still struggling, so I don't know what I can share. Enjoy writing, I think that's the only thing I can say, right? If you enjoy writing, write from your heart, and it makes you happy, that's good. Where is it that you would suggest going on a solo travel, just like you and nature? This really depends on where you live. So I'm sure there's so many options. Just pack your bags and go to the mountains. Who's your inspiration? Actually, I can't think of anybody. There have been so many people. Who's my inspiration? Oh yeah, I should say this 100-year-old yoga teacher. She is amazing. She's 99 now. Ta Pochon Lynch. She is just so inspirational and so amazing. You know, her whole theories on aging and I mean, she's 99 years, you know, the thing she does, you must watch her interviews and videos. Okay, how many countries have you traveled to today, which is your most favorite dream destination? Completed around 40 countries, and as I said earlier, yeah, Japan is one of my favorite countries. Do you travel alone? If yes, how do you feel while experiencing different cultures and things? I sometimes travel alone. I sometimes just me and my kids, sometimes all of us as family, sometimes me and my friends. So just I travel in various different combinations. And how do I feel? I always just feel happy. I mean, I always feel excited too, you know, when I land in a new country, when I reach a new place to kind of explore a new culture. It's always an exciting feeling. How good did you feel after your head shape, and how soon will you be able to see that beautiful ball look of yours? I felt amazing. I mean, it was so liberating. It was so amazing, and there's no hairbrush, nothing. It was just so easy and convenient. And how soon? Yeah, I would love to do it again. I mean, they've been, you know, I was talking to somebody regarding making a video on it and stuff that I didn't really go through. If it's for a project, I wouldn't mind even doing it tomorrow. If any project interests me, there have been people who approach me, but yes, if something interests me, I can go shave tomorrow. But if it's otherwise, I just want to grow my hair for now, for some time, just for a change, maybe sometime in the future. Okay, your outfits are awesome. Where do you get so much inspiration from? Inspiration is everywhere. Every city I visit. When I was in Banaras, I was so inspired so much from the Ganga Aarti, the, you know, cream and gold flow of the fabric. So, but every day I'm just inspired by Bangkok, this crazy city. There's so much, you know, the inspiration is all around me, nature, on the streets. So if ever I make a collection, I think it'll be really inspired, you know, by Bangkok, my last 10 years in this city. So it'll be an eclectic mix of all the crazy things which this city has taught me. Abhishek, gym or yoga classes? It depends, whatever. Find what you love and do that. You know, if you don't like it, you wouldn't end up doing it. But for me, I love yoga, but there are times I just have to balance it with weight training and Muay Thai and different things which I honestly don't love, and I have to force myself to do it, because just sometimes from the physical aspect, like I have these really, you know, sometimes it just helps to get a mix in. So yeah, but I think it's easier when you find that one thing you love, you refuse to be committed to it. But if that's not giving you the results you want, then sometimes you'll have to mix it up. But on every day, for every day, just find the one thing you love, and as far as fitness is concerned, and stick to that. What about journey to Sri Lanka? I've been there twice and I really want to go back. I love the country. Actually, thrice, yeah. I'll go back sometime for sure. It's a beautiful country. Here's two more questions. I totally forgot. Sorry, I'm just going to do them quickly now. I got inspired by your look a lot, and I'm shaving my hair too. What is the reason behind your head shave, and what made you do that? Well, I went for trekking to Sandakfu, and I don't know, when I was just coming down, I think it was just the mountains, everything, I just felt like I really wanted to shave my head. So that's when I shaved. It was the quickest decision, and it was the most liberating feeling. It was amazing. Okay, the next one. You have visited a lot of countries and cities. Within that, which city is good for living in peace? Also, which country is safe? Honestly, it sounds so cliche. You got to find the peace within yourself. If you don't find peace within yourself, no place is peaceful like that. Yes, safe, I will tell you. But yeah, peace, you'll have to find within yourself. Safe, I think the safest country is undoubtedly Singapore. I just find it so safe. At least, I mean, I could just leave my kids. They can go down the road. It's really a very safe country. Bye-bye.